What is up, brother? Daneil Logan, Boba Fett here to answer your questions.
Boba Fett? Where?
Boba Fett is a very mysterious character, and if it wasn't for the fans, you know, he wouldn't be, you know, the character he is.
One helmeted bounty hunter that looked unbelievably cool has spawned an entire, you know, mythology within this bigger mythology, an entire race of people, Mandalorians, you know, it's amazing. And the word Mandalorian never appears in a Star Wars film. You have to go back to the Empire Strikes Back sketchbook that has concept drawings of what Boba Fett was back in the days when he was called a super commando.
And Boba Fett appears as a cartoon character. I think that's his first appearance, just after 78. The holiday special.
I am Boba Fett.
And the very first day was a scene with all the bounty hunters. And all I was doing was just standing and looking at Darth Vader occasionally.
No disintegrations.
As you wish.
I remember my younger son saying, isn't it funny you put a bucket over your head, Dad, and, you know, and people think you're rather cool.
He's all yours, bounty hunter.
It was very exciting because the first real science fiction film I'd done.
Put Captain Solo in the cargo hold.
Human, yes. Origin, unknown. Planet, unknown. He was quite a special character. It's the mystery behind this uniform. You need to see the film several times to think, why does he wear this death head on his epaulette? They had little knee pads where I could fire darts with. They were Velcroed on, and by the end of the day, they'd obviously slipped round, so you'd have to keep shifting them. And if I walked, which I didn't do much of, they'd shoot across the room because the Velcro would snap off and fly. It wasn't easy.
This is from Empire, and there's Boba Fett on set with his knee pads on upside down.
A great deal of fans, 98% of fans, want to know more about him.
Now, flash forward through the years as the expanded universe began to take shape, there began to be many stories about Mandalorians. All these different stories. Fast forward to Attack the Clones.
Much rain as we can get, much wind as we can get.
One of the great things about Episode 2 is it really delivers on this mysterious and wonderful character, Boba Fett.
Boba Fett, yes! With the helmet and he's a bounty hunter, that is awesome, man. That is so cool.
Yeah, and in the second movie, you get to see him as a little kid.
Because Boba Fett's like 11 years old in this one.
Come back on Monday, I think, to fly his spaceships. Can you do that? Fly through asteroids? Fight? Shoot?
There's a guy named Jango Fett. Suddenly, Boba Fett's a clone of this guy, Jango Fett.
I guess he's the original bounty hunter then.
Temeura Morrison was a very, very famous actor who came out in New Zealand, so every single person in my country knew who he was.
As far as I'm concerned, you don't even work here yet.
It doesn't have to be a caesarean.
Anything is too dangerous.
Not if you know what you're doing.
You're not in Guatemala now, Dr. Robita.
Once were warriors. The story of one woman's fight for freedom.
You're a hard lady, baby. You're a hard man, Jake.
People say their true feelings when they try.
Went to meet Temeura Morrison for the first time. I was so intimidated because of his fame and who he was.
I told you about this thing, eh?
You're still a slave, Jake. To your fist. To the drink.
I'm a lovable chip.
To yourself.
I was kind of nervous. So he walked up to me with, obviously, the Jango Fett helmet and the costume on, and he looked at me and he says, played my son. And I said, yes, I am. And he goes, all right, well,
call me Dad now, while we're here. Okay, I'll call you son, you know, just so we get the bit of bond.
Ever since that moment, we've had a father and son, relationship and bond.
Good MC George, the director. Ask him what your motivation, all right?
The biggest thing of all, he's pretty cool, yeah.
May the force be with me.
Again, I don't really care about him when he was a little kid. I like the ship and the helmet and the killing people.
Draw your guns and pow, pow, pow.
The fight scene with Obi-Wan Kenobi. The space chase through asteroid planets. And the helmet, of course. And that got a bit
bit much in the rain sometimes.
Believe me, this is rain. This is real rain.
You know, while you're doing your action and your fight scenes...
Then the thing fogs up, I can't see anything. Oh, well, I'll just carry on like this. I can just see this blur coming down.
Being a strong, virile Maori warrior from New Zealand, well, you just got to deal with these elements and carry on. Thank goodness for those stunt doubles.
It wouldn't rain up in space.
No, he's like this little kid, and then his dad dies, and he's very sad. Do not give a shit at all about that.
I think the fact that Boba Fett's, you know, an orphan makes him somewhat of a sympathetic character, but not weak.
And then George Lucas tells me one day, we're going to put the Mandalorians in the Clone Wars. And I go, oh boy, that's interesting. Because let me show you this. And I moved this big pile of material over and I said, this is everything. This is everything that the Mandalorians are right now. And so George and I do what we always do when we come across something that I know exists well in the EU. We go over it all.
I am not the creator of RJ, and I want you to get out of this office right now.
I was very honored and excited to be asked to come back to play Boba again, because I'm a big Clone Wars fan. Having his father's face everywhere he goes is kind of difficult, but Boba feels he's a unique child of Jango Fett, and all the rest of these are just clones.
We're all in it together, right?
Thanks, but I can handle myself.
He feels he's old enough to kind of do whatever he wants now, and or try to do whatever he wants. You definitely get to see a little bit of a darker side in Boba, and more or less him growing up a little. Clone Wars animation just blows every other animation out of the water. When I walked out of the screening, I thought they were some of the best episodes that I've seen from Clone Wars. And I know the fans are really going to be blown away by what they see. It's going to keep them wanting to see more and more, just like me.
What's happening with the Star Wars spinoff involving Boba Fett?
Yes, well, I live down in New Zealand, so this is part of my reason for being here. Actually, I like to come up and see my son again and see him meet people like Todd and come to this wonderful place of Tennessee where I've never been before. So another reason also is to catch up with my agent in Hollywood, find out about all the gossip. I heard Disney's taken up the whole Star Wars franchise now, so it's might be a good time just to show my face around.
Also, what do I think about him in the Mandalorian? I thought he was badass.
I feel real honored to bring back this character and become the son of Jango. He's the kingpin. He's the kingpin of the galaxy. You don't want to mess with this guy. It's like when you walk into those cowboy bars and the saloon doors open. And then the first thing you're going to find out is who's the number one gunslinger around here. Otherwise, you're dead. So I'm that guy.
Another thing about this character, Boba, you know, the fight and the way he fights. I'm actually drawing a lot on my Maori traditional side thing called the haka. Ha is the breath. Ka is fire. Fire breath.
Temeura happened to show John his traditional Maori dance, which is a lot of the spinning of the stick, stomping the tongue out and everything. And John saw that and he asked me if we could do anything with that style and make it fit. After we talked about it, we told Josh to start making this Maori weapon.
Temeura specifically requested his own gaffy stick. He wanted one that was longer and the other one was more slender. If you look at the other ones from the earlier films, it's a much more, the shaft is just thicker and wider. Didn't lend itself to the choreography that he wanted for his fight. So we wanted to make sure we had something specific that he could have the action. The action's pretty brutal. He's really gonna go after some stormtroopers. So I'm pretty excited about that.
I'm so glad that he managed to come back. As a big Star Wars fan myself, it has obviously kept the cloning process. So let's hope for many more stories of other Boba Fett ventures and different things of the galaxy that Boba explores. So. Thank you for your wonderful questions, and also have a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, or whatever the holiday you celebrate. Happiest of holidays, and the best and better 2021 to you. Take care.